Hi, I'm Jared with Orenda, and today I'm going to show you how to finish out a startup tank. When you get the barrels, they come with a lid, the tank, and the ports are already welded into the barrel itself. On our website, we have a startup tank parts list that you can download, and you can find these parts at any home improvement store. Once you have the parts and tools necessary to begin assembling the startup tank, we're gonna start with the water source. You need a hose bib Y to connect a hose to the tank and a hose to fill the pool. Make sure the hose bib Y has valves on it so you can adjust the water flow going to the tank. From there, you take your water hose connected here. Your water hose is then gonna connect to the hose bib going into the tank, which is a 3/4 inch threaded inlet on this side. Once you have the hose bib here threaded into the tank and nice and tight, you're good to go there. That is where you run into your swivel. You need a swivel to be able to connect the hose bib here to the water hose coming from the water source. Like this, the swivel connects these together. So once you have your hose bib on this end of the inlet, you can start on the inside of the tank. The inside of the tank takes a 3/4 inch threaded 90, which threads right in. This is a slip 90 on the inside because I'm going to cut a piece, a 3/4 inch PVC to the correct length. So what you do is you drop your pipe into the tank and you want the bottom of the 3/4 inch PVC to be about a 1/2 inch to 1 inch off the bottom of the barrel. Double check the length to make sure that it's going to be roughly 1 inch to 1/2 inch off the bottom of the barrel. Now it's time to glue the 3/4 inch PVC pipe inside the barrel. Next, we're going to move on to the outlet of the tank. There's nothing that you really need to do to the inside of the tank because water's going to be flowing out. You need 1.5 inch threaded 90 by slip. Once you get it threaded nice and tight, we're gonna move on to the 1.5 inch slip. Well, it's a threaded nipple, but I cut it in half so that I can make it a slip. Make sure it fits in here. Now it's time to glue. Next, we're gonna move on to the barbed nipple. You can buy this in different forms. You can have a slip, a thread, any way to really just get it connected. We chose to go with a threaded one just because every pool guy is gonna have a threaded high temp nipple. We're just gonna thread this onto the bottom of that nipple. Once it's nice and tight, for the most part, your tank is good to go. We have to connect the plug that goes onto the bottom. This plug is gonna be what you take out to drain the tank after the pool is full. Finish it off with a pair of channel locks to get it on there really well. Once you have this complete, you need to get your pool hose, pool vac hose. I recommend you have at least 12 to 15 feet of vac hose, and really it just depends on how deep of a pool you're filling. You want it to be able to reach the deep end where the main drains are. So like I said, it varies place to place. This is where your clamp comes in handy. Put the clamp on the bottom of your barbed nipple, connect your vac hose. Next, what you need to do on the end of your hose going into the pool, you need tape, you need floats, a zip tie, and a sock. I know we all have these loose socks laying around our house, so this shouldn't be a problem at all. What you want to do with the sock is slip it around the end of the vac hose, pull it on, and you wanna leave yourself probably 3 or 4 inches worth of room so that things can gather in the bottom, and zip tie this to the vac hose. This prevents the calcium dusting from gathering on the bottom of the pool. This will catch most of that dust that comes out of the bottom of the vac hose. So once you're done here, cut the end of the zip tie so that it doesn't scratch anything up. Once you have that part, you need floats. So as the pool is filling, the end of this will float as it's going up. You're gonna tape all of your water hoses and fill hoses to this. So the fill hose coming from the house or any of the other hoses that you wanna run in there, the more hoses into the pool, the faster it fills, the better it's gonna be. So all the hoses that you're running in here, tape them to this fill. This is a transmission fluid funnel with a flex pipe on the end of it. Once you get your barrel filled with calcium and water, this is where you're going to insert the funnel into the port going out so that you can add the SC1000 that drops into this tube that'll go directly in the pool as there's 200 to 300 gallons in the bowl of the pool. And this is something you just take in and out and it removes easily. So if you have any questions, please visit our website, call us. And like I said, we're gonna have more tools and resources available to guide you during the startup tank process.